This is Shelley Kraft coming to you live on SNN Live. We're coming to you from the New Orleans Investment Conference 2017 in New Orleans. I have with me Derek Iwanaka from First Mining Finance. It's a publicly traded company. I'm going to give you two symbols. It's FF on the TSXV and FFMGF in the U.S. on OTC markets. Welcome back to SNN Live.
Thank you very much, Shelley. Thanks for having me on.
Good to have you. Let's get started with a brief overview of the company, and then we'll go from there.
Okay. So First Mining, we started a couple years ago now by a man named Keith Newmar. He's the same person who started First Quantum Minerals and First Majestic Silver. And really what we wanted to create was a mineral bank that has kind of changed. The strategy now has really evolved into more of a developing company now, so we're actually moving forward with some of our projects. At some point, we will look to sell some of those assets or spin them out and monetize them. But what we're really at the stage right now is a developer stage.
So what's the history of the company? And tell our audience.
What's the history of the company? Well, I mean, we've only been around for a couple of years. And really, we came out of the gates really hard and fast. So we went out, we took over essentially eight companies over the course of 12 months. And we finished off last year with a $27 million financing. And now what we're doing is we looked around kind of towards the end of last year, and it was just so tough to find good acquisitions at a reasonable cost. And so what we decided to do was put money into the ground and start developing our assets and start to drill some of them. And so that's exactly what we've been doing for the last 12 months. We've been drilling on our projects. We've been moving projects to preliminary economic assessment stages. And eventually what we will do is push some of them through with the permitting. But ultimately what we would want to do is either sell them, spin them out, and then hold on to a metal stream or a royalty.
So Derek, any more updates?
Absolutely. So just about a month ago, we released a preliminary economic assessment from our Spring Pole project. It had terrific economics. It has 26% post-tax IRR. It has an NPV of almost $800 million. And the market kind of yawned at it. It was a kind of a tough time to actually be releasing such good news. Gold had gone down about $100 an ounce at the time. And so really we were focusing on moving that project forward. I think there is some skepticism around the project in that some people think it's difficult to get the permitting. And I'm not, for us, we think it will be a challenge, but we think it's absolutely attainable. Our permitting team is working on it right now. And by the end of this year, we look to present or submit a project description to the government. And that will start really the clock running for the permitting work. And we think that's probably going to take between 2 to 3 years to permit.
How is First Mining differentiated?
I think what kind of differentiates us is really we have Keith Newmar, who's the man who started First Quantum and First Majestic. But also, I mean, we have a terrific track record. I mean, in the first 13 months of the company's history, we made 8 acquisitions. You have to have a good track record if you're going to convince that many different management teams to accept your shares in exchange for theirs and really walk out the door and call it quits. So we've had a great track record, I think.
What's the value catalyst?
I think the value catalyst going forward for here from here is that we have to get a new resource estimate probably out for our Golden project. Once that's out, we would probably move that towards a preliminary economic assessment. I think we also want to see the permitting go forward with our Spring Pole project, and those should generate some good catalysts. And in addition to that, we'll have some drill results coming out of both our Golden project and Hope Brook in Newfoundland.
What's your backup plan?
We don't really need too much of a backup plan, just because if gold prices were, say, to go down, that just gives us another opportunity to really go out and make acquisitions. If the gold price were to go up, which I suspect it probably will, then really that makes all the value of our projects higher. I mean, they're going to be more economic than they already are, and so that would be terrific either way.
Tell us about the management team.
Management team, so Keith Newmar, as I said before, I mean, he is the man who first started off First Quantum Minerals in the 90s, and then First Majestic Silver in the early 2000s. Our CEO is Dr. Chris Osterman. He is the one who is instrumental with the discovery of the San Jose deposit, which Fortuna Silver is now mining. And then we have Patrick Donnelly. He's a geologist, but also he's got a lot of experience in the capital side. He worked for Solomon Partners, so he was a mining analyst for over 4 years. And then he has some corporate experience as well, so he's been with a couple of copper developing companies.
Let's get your website out there for more information.
Sure, www.firstminingfinance.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, Derek Iwanaka, First Mining Finance. It's a publicly traded company. I'm going to give you two symbols, FF on the TSXV and FFMGF in the U.S. on OTC markets. I'm Shelley Kraft. This is SNN Live, and we're coming to you live from the New Orleans Investment Conference 2017 right here in New Orleans. Derek, always good to see you. Thanks,
Shelley,
for coming on.
Thank you very much for having me on again.